It's nice to be here, and it's nice to make an exposition of the Word of God as we make our try and our effort to glean some truths in the Scripture, especially in connection to the topic that is being given to me by Elder Donnie. And you know what? I'm always afraid, especially Donnie. The name Donnie is around me, you know, because Daniel means God is my judge. And it seems that I am in the judgment seat right now. But you know what, when I heard and the appointment is fixed that I will be speaking on this day, on this 11th day, I said to Elder Donnie, give me 2 to 3 days to think of it. Because I want to pray and I want to have a blessing from the Lord if the Lord will drive me here to speak the word, to edify this congregation and to uplift the soul which is being wearied by the situations of our time. At this moment, I would like to thank especially for this church and to Sister Daphne for lending me this this pulpit. This is your schedule today, Sister Daphne. And when I'm there sitting and listening to your Sabbath school leading in the class, I think and I felt that, you know, I am lacking to take her place. You know, what a nice exposition, a nice study, and nice personality. And that should be the reflection of your walk with your God. Before we make a sort of exposition, a study of the Word of God, may I invite the congregation to please bow your head as we pray and as we approach the Lord. Gracious Lord in heaven, dispense to us, Lord, the spiritual food that we need today. Lord, in this church, you have given the spirit of prophecy and the eternal truth that is of eternal verity. Lord, as we come to worship you and expound your word before this congregation, I pray, Lord, that in this empty seat, your angels will sit, and at the seat and behind the pulpit, you will preach to us. I am submitting myself to you, O Lord. Let the Lord speak to this church through me. I am your vessel, yet I am so happy for giving these privileges. Let the church be blessed today in Jesus' name. Amen. If there is one truth that we need to look on and to ponder as a church is to note three lines that we as part of this church cannot separate and cannot deviate from it. This truth is written in three thoughts and three lines, and these thoughts goes and grows within the fiber of our being as a church. That Christ has died, Christ has risen, and Christ will come again. Amen. Could we say amen to that?
Amen.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, is a past event. But Christ will come again is a past event. That the coming of Jesus Christ is fast approaching. And as a church, we are encouraged to look on this great event that the church is prepared, that the church is made to. We as a church is living in this world. And one text that I could not separate myself as I try to ponder on this thought is the text in Titus chapter 2 verse 13. And I love this text especially when I ponder on Christ coming again. It says here in Titus chapter 2, verse 13. I would like you to notice the first word Paul used here in writing to Titus. Paul said, while we look forward with hope to that wonderful day when the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, will be what? Will be revealed. There is a insertion of what? You know, this is a very short word, but this has long implication. That while we wait, 2,000 years that the church is waiting for Christ. The coming of Christ was preached during the time of the apostles, and it is still being preached today. But Christ is not yet here on earth. Then he made his promise laid aside. Are we as a church left with his promise, and yet Jesus Christ will not come? 164 years ago, on the same land, on the same mouth of our pioneers, the coming of Jesus Christ was preached. Here on America, the Spirit is being revived on that moment that the Word has given this privilege, and they were encouraged to turn and to tune again their lives to Jesus Christ. That in 1844, it is preached that Jesus will come again. People are encouraged. They look with full anticipation. The promise that is being rung in their ears. But yet, years, decades, and century ago, Christ is not yet here. But we as a church cannot be moved. Because we as a church is given this mission. Maybe our mission is not yet done. So why Christ is not yet coming? Church, if you want that Christ will come soon, leave everything that occupies you. Give your life to Jesus and make your time occupied with missionary work. And surely you will not ask that question before, because before you ask that question, Christ will set up his timetable on coming here on earth. Because his church, his people, is knowing and preparing the world for his second coming. Amen. Let that event be done in our life. Let that event be our anticipation. You know what? As we look on the promise of Jesus coming, many churches today, even biblical scholars, are not so much in fun and interested with Jesus coming. They thought that the coming of Jesus Christ is a mythology. It's like an adventure. It's an outdated event, and it has no place in our modern society. They thought that Jesus Christ lived here as a historical figure, and after he left us with all these things, then he is gone. Nothing consideration on this world. They thought that the coming of Jesus Christ is a barbaric event. Maybe